Hello friends, I am Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today I am going to cover up the binary search iterative programming C language. This is one of the searching technique. I am going to explain it with the help of program in C language. Before moving to binary search, I would like to explain the need of searching technique. I have already explained the need of searching technique in my previous video. For this, I am providing a shortcut key over here. You can go through that video. You can see how the searching is needed or important in our day-to-day life. Then you can continue with this video. Again, before moving to binary search, the introduction of binary search, importance of binary search, and the examples of binary search are already explained in the introduction of binary search video. For that video also, I am providing a shortcut link in this write-up corner. Now, I will continue with a short introduction about binary search. This binary search always works on sorted list of the elements. If you are not having a sorted list, then you can't perform a binary search. You can't apply binary search on that. If you want to perform binary search on given data set, then you need to check whether your list is sorted or not. If it is not, make it sorted and then go for a binary search. Why the list should be in sorted form? For this, I'll give the answer very soon. Next, if I want to perform a binary search every time, searching that will be is nothing but the searching of key value in a given sorted list or array, we can say that. Whenever I will perform a binary search, I will reduce my list into the two half parts, and that is nothing but this is called as successive elimination of half of the array. That is nothing but dividing the list into two sub-lists, in the left sub-list as well as in the right sub-list. How we are going to perform all these things are already explained in introduction wala video. This technique is called as divide and conquer technique because it divides the list and conquers the required results. So that's why this is called as divide and conquer technique. And this technique, this searching technique, can be implemented in two ways. The first one is you can use the loop. This is also called as the iterative execution or implementation of binary search. Or the another way is recursive, where recursive function you can use for the implementation of binary search. In this current video, I am going to explain you the implementation of binary search with loop or with the iteration. Before moving to a program, I would like to explain different test cases. Here, I have used the sorted list. As I explained previously, the binary search works only on a sorted list. This is the limitation of binary search. If you don't have a list in a sorted form, then you need to make it sorted, then you need to apply the binary search. Now here I have taken the list which is already in sorted form. I have taken 7 numbers. This table is I am going to use to explain you the test cases where the keys which we are going to search in the given values I have mentioned over here. With this, the three columns, like the position of low variable, position of high variable, position of mid variable. This low is nothing but the lower boundary of your list. High is nothing but the higher boundary of your list. Mid is nothing but the mid or the center, middle point of your list. Every time you need to check whether your key value is equal to midpoint or not. If it is equal, your search is successful. If it is not equal, you need to take a decision whether to move into the left sub list or into the right sub list. This mid is going to divide our list into two lists. Now, all these things we are going to perform, we can perform if my list is in the sorted form. If my list is not in the sorted form, I can't perform all these things. Now, let's start with the first key where I'm going to compare, I'm going to check whether this 60 is present in my list or not. So I'll start with low at the 0 position, which is lower boundary. High is at the 6th position, which is nothing but the higher boundary, and I'll find out a mid. How to find out a mid is also explained in introduction of binary search. So here 40 is going to become mid, that is position 3. I'll compare 60 with 40, are they equal? No. Then I need to take decision whether to move into the left sublist or move to the right sublist. Here 60 is greater than the mid, means what? The rest of the list, that is right sublist, may be having the number 60. So that's why I need to update the lower boundary to make this right sublist as the current list. So my low will be 4, my high will be as it is, and I need to make find out a new mid, that is nothing but 60. Now I will compare this 60 with my key value. Are they equal? Yes, they are equal, and that's why I will show the result, that the result is successful. Now let's go forward for 75. In the same way, this will be the lower boundary, this will be the higher boundary. I will check whether my mid, that is 40, is less than or greater than or equal to 75. It is not equal to, so I'll check whether it, if it is greater than, I need to move to the right sublist. I'm going to update my low value. The lower boundary is nothing but position 4, that is 50, and higher boundary is 70, is at 70. My new mid is 60. I need to check whether 75 is greater than 60. Yes, it is greater. That's why I need to move to the right subtree again, right sublist again. Now my updated low is nothing but 6. So my low is also at the position 6. My high is also at the position 6. So my mid is at the position 6 again. I need to check whether my 75 is less than 70, greater than 70 or equal to 70. It is not equal, but it is greater. So I need to move to the next right sublist. For moving to the right sublist, I need to update my low position. My low position is going to become 7 and high is at position 6. The low and high are crossing their position, it means that this is not the valid list. If the valid list is not present, it means that my key is not present in my list. That's why search is unsuccessful. In the same way, we'll search for the next number 28. Let's start with the same. Low is at position 0, high is at position 6, mid is at position 40. 28 is less than 40. We need to move to the left sublist. So in this case, I need to update my high. If I'll update my high, is now my new updated high is at position 2, that is at the number 30. And now updated mid is nothing but 20. Mid is at the position 20. Now here what I need to do, I need to check whether the 28 is less than equal to 20, greater than equal to 20, greater than 20 or equal to 20. So 28 is greater than 20, so I need to move to the right sublist. I will update my low with the position 2, updated position 2. High is also at position 2. And now mid is also at position 2. At the mid position, number is not present. I need to check whether the 28 is less than 30. Yes, it is less than 30. So I need to move to the left sublist where I need to update the high. High will be at position 1. Here you can see that low is at position 2, high is at position 1. They are crossing their position. It indicates that my list is not valid. And it indicates that my search is unsuccessful. So in this way, these are the three different cases which I am going to assume for the execution of this binary search. In the next slide, I am going to explain you the implementation of binary searching technique with the help of C program with iteration. Here you can see that I have used the same variables, that they are low to indicate lower boundary, high to indicate higher boundary, middle to indicate the mid of the list, n are the number of elements present in my array, key which I am going to search, and array is a variable where I am going to provide or store a list. I am going to explain the value of n, that is how many numbers are there into the array, then I'm going to accept all that n values, then I'm going to search for a key. Here I'm going to initialize low equal to 0, that is 0th position, high is at n minus 1. N minus is nothing but my higher boundary, and here I'm going to find out the mid. Low plus high divided by 2 is nothing but the formula to find out the mid. I need to check whether my low is less than or equal to high. If they are crossing their position, it indicates that the number is not present. If low is next to the high, then it indicates that number is not present and your search is unsuccessful. But I need to perform all these tasks till while my low is less than or equal to high. If my low is less than or equal to high, it indicates that my list is a valid list. And I need to check whether my middle is less than my key. If my mid, the value present at the mid is less than the key value, then we need to reduce the list to the right sublist, and we need to update my lower bound boundary to the mid plus 1. Else, if this is not the case, I need to check whether they are equal. If they are equal, then my key search is successful. I need to display the position and I need to break the loop. And if it is also, means if it is not less than, if it is not equal, then it must be greater than. In that case, I need to reduce my list to the left sublist, and I need to update in that case the upper bound of my list by subtracting 1 from the mid. So high is updated. In this case, I need to recalculate the mid by applying a formula again, recalculation, and then it will check whether my low is less than or equal to high again. If it is the case, for the updated sublist, it will perform the same task again. So in this way, you can implement the searching, binary searching technique with the help of iteration or with the help of while loop. Here I need to explain, or I would like to explain, the advantages of binary search, that is, practically it is widely used, significantly faster searching technique in comparison with the linear search because it is having the less time complexity. But what are the disadvantages? This is not as simple as the linear search. Linear search is very simple for the implementation, as well as binary search works only for the sorted list. If my list is not in the sorted form, the binary search cannot be applied. What is time complexity of binary search? Time complexity of binary search is nothing but O log n. How to calculate this binary search time complexity? I am going to explain it in my next video. Please stay tuned with my channel to find out the time complexity for a binary search. So thank you, dear friends, for listening and watching my video. If you would like to if you like the content of my video, please do not forget to give the comment. If you like the content and the video, please like the video. Subscribe my channel Tech Talks. I am providing you the subscription link over here. And do not forget to share it with your friends. Again, keep your bell ringing, which will give you the notification of new videos in my channel. Here, I am providing you the subscription link. Please do subscribe my channel. Keep the bell ringing, which will give you the notification. Along with this, I am providing you the shortcut for some of the few more videos that will be helpful for you. Thank you.